but attractive font, use a consistent format, and if you do need to use tables to achieve that consistent format, try and make sure that you don't use visible cell lines.
In your CV, remember to also include your successes and achievements. Include what impact you had in that job. What success did you have? What did you learn? What did you achieve?
A good piece of advice for your CV is to try and quantify your achievements in some way. So if you can add numbers, say you raise some money for a club or society or a charity, then it'd be great to know what that figure was.
So when you're writing about your work experience on a CV, try and get your most relevant experience in the most prominent place, which is bang on the front page. If you need to, use a relevant experience section to achieve this, and then an additional section for most recent but less relevant experience.
Think about your profile. What is unique about you? What sets you apart from your peers and the competition that is out there? And maybe start by saying something that grabs the employer's attention.
Your spelling and grammar are really important on your CV. We all make mistakes, but it's a good idea to get a friend to check everything through for you before you submit your final application. They might spot things that you haven't.
The Careers Service can also offer you feedback on your CV or cover letters or applications, and these can be for jobs or for further study. Have a look on our website to find out more.